Hi everybody. Today I am going to talk about a new chapter, the quality control in homeopathy. Quality control is the total procedure for providing standard medicine to the patients. You know, quality control is a term that refers to the process involved in maintaining the quality and validity of a manufactured product. You know, an analytical control laboratory is responsible for testing and approving the raw materials, the packing materials, intermediate products, and the finished products. In every manufacturing unit, the quality control procedures, starting with the receipt of raw materials and continuing throughout the production process, packaging, operations, finished product testing, its documentation, its surveillance, and its distribution. You know, the process in homeopathic prescribing is based upon the purity and the quality of raw materials and the finished products. A substandard drug will not produce desired result in a sick individual. Our master, Dr. Hanuman, was fully aware of the quality of homeopathic medicines, which he mentioned in his Organon of Medicine, like in the aphorism 264 of 6th edition of Organon of Medicine. He says that the true physician must be provided with genuine medicines of unimpaired strength so that he may be able to rely upon their therapeutic powers. He must be able himself to judge their genuineness. And also, in the aphorism 265 of 6th edition of Organon of Medicine, he says that it should be a matter of conscience with him to be thoroughly convinced in every case that the patients always take the right medicine, and therefore he must give the patient the correctly chosen medicine prepared, moreover, by himself. Now, let's see the objectives of quality control. The objectives of quality control of the finished products are like: observe the quality specifications, maintaining the correct ingredients in the correct proportions in the medicines, the purity maintaining throughout the process, the medicines are properly manufactured according to the pharmacopoeia specifications, like in Homoeopathic Pharmacopoeia of India, Homoeopathic Pharmacopoeia of US, British Homoeopathic Pharmacopoeia, etc. The medicines packaged in suitable containers. Affix proper labels on the containers. Proper storage for maintaining proper quality of the medicine. These are the objectives of quality control in homeopathy. Now, come into the factors or parameters for quality control in. There are various factors are related to the quality control process, which has a great role in obtaining a standard quality, which is starting from the raw materials to the finished products. Now, let's see what are the prime factors of quality control in homeopathy. You should be aware of the qualities of all materials from the raw material to the finished products, including the packaging materials must be carefully controlled and supervised. We should maintain a proper system must be evolved for purchase and receipt of material and raw products, their testings, storage, and finally their issues for the manufacture of dosage forms. Then we should keep proper records for all such transactions. We should conform to all drug substances as well as the vehicles and other non-drug components to the specified standard as in the pharmacopoeia of purity, quality, and freedom from toxicity. And also, we should adapt a similar procedure concerning containers, closures, cartons, labels, etc. Now come to the selection of personnel for various works. We should maintain a proper HR system, that is human resource system, for the selection of personnel who involved in the processing, packaging, and other related works. Give them proper training in their concerned fields. We should be careful about the selection of the equipment, because the equipment used in the manufacturing process is very important, because it maintains the quality of the products. So the equipment must be accurate and capable of reproducing quality as per specifications. The environment under which the raw material are stored, processed, and packaged are also very important, because the environments in which the processing is done is important, because any contamination of pollutants may deteriorate the quality of products. That's all for today. Remaining part of this chapter will continue in the next video. I hope this video is useful for you to an easy understanding of the subject. Don't forget to subscribe to this channel and click the bell button to receive all my future updates. Let me conclude. Thank you for watching.